Another scenario would be, let's say there is a couple who did really well. They didn't save a lot, but they bought a home and they paid it off. So now they have a ton of equity in their home. He had a great job, has a huge pension, and that's what they've been living on. So they didn't have to worry about having a 401k or IRA, right? So they probably have both a pension and Social Security. And so they have a cash flow every month, living the good life in retirement. What people don't always think about, because it's uncomfortable, is death. So did they plan for when he dies? Now, it's just statistically true that men are going to die before a woman, typically. Sure. Okay. So he passes before she does. And maybe what they didn't think about is how that Social Security check is going to cut. Maybe not quite in half, but overnight, they're going to take part of that check away. Also, that pension check may disappear completely or cut in half. So now their income, her income that she's left with, is half. Can she continue the same lifestyle without his portion of the income? Usually no, right? What are you gonna do now? Now she's mourning the loss of her loved one and she has to figure this out on her own. What does she do? This is when they usually come calling. Hey, can we get a reverse mortgage? That's actually all I've got. So she becomes a need. She wasn't a need, never thought she would become a need, never thought her income was gonna cut in half because they've just always been together and shared everything, right? So once those income buckets disappear, is oftentimes another time that people should and will be calling for a reverse mortgage. Now, I wish that they would have called me earlier when they could have made a decision together, right? Talked about their finances. What are you going to need? Let's plan and put this in place so that when one of us does pass, typically it's going to be him first, that you now have a bucket of money to draw on. And she can do that instantaneously without worrying about it in the midst of mourning.